So, Brian, what are we wearing today?
Oh, cool. So, I got my soft back plate and wing here. Got a steel 80, my little short steel 80. Got my 62X first stage here with two dual adjustable second stages, primary and alternate, of course. Of course, I've got just a single pressure gauge. It's from the Marez XR line. Nothing fancy there. As far as mask, I've got my Marez X Vision mask. I've got to add my GoPro. We're going out to do some surveying today. Of course, I've got a compass. I've got my survey slates that we do mapping projects with. I've also got a Ratio IX3M2 GPS deep computer. This is a new computer. If you've not seen our review on this, check out the link below and I'll link it somewhere up top for you too. The reason I'm using this computer today is I've got to get the GPS coordinates of where we're at. And instead of using my phone to do that, I'm actually going to be using this computer. So it's a really cool feature that's built in. It's got a GPS tracker in it, so it's really cool. It helps with mapping projects, things like that. Of course, I've got my wreck or cave reel here because we are going to be mapping stuff underwater and we've got to be able to track it off. I've got my Comfort Zone Scuba dry suit. Even though we're in summertime and the water's warm, I don't feel like getting wet today. I've got to work the shop after we get done, so of course I've got it. And then, of course, my PFD for the ride up. But that's, yeah, it's pretty much what I'm wearing. And of course, as always, my trusty dusty Avanti Quattros. That's pretty much what I'm wearing on today's dive. What's up, guys? It's Brian again from Lake Hickory Scuba and Marine. If you are new to our channel, do me a huge favor. Hit this little subscribe button right here and ding that little bell as well. That way you guys are going to be notified every time we upload new content. Now, we are headed out to do an underwater survey for a client, and I want to kind of show you the equipment that we wear when we do that. Now, with that being said, definitely stay tuned because we're going to be showing you in a separate video the actual underwater survey and how we actually conduct those and why we conduct them as well. But I'm going to walk up here and show you what my dive buddy Travis is wearing today because he's new to this. He's new to the commercial side of diving, and of course I'm going to be training him as well, but I want to show you his equipment setup just to show you you can wear standard scuba equipment to do stuff like that. So with that being said, let's walk up here and see what Travis is wearing. Travis, you ready for today's dive?
I'm ready for today, Brian. How about you?
I absolutely. What are you wearing today?
Well, I'm going to be dry suit diving as well as you today just because we're learning how to do the dry suit thing as well.
Awesome.
I'm diving with a tall 80 where you're diving with a short.
Okay.
Aluminum. I have the Marez 62X first stage, the double adjustable, obviously. Okay. Flashlight, SMB, Marez, XR. Back plate and wing, just the typical everything, standard mask, Marez spider. Mask, yeah. I've got the spider. I like the spider. It fits me well. I have a small I-frame, so it works out well for me. But yeah, I'm ready to rock and roll. Obviously, we're the same fins as you. Got my Genius computer, so we're going to log our dive today on this and see how everything is so we can go back and...
Cool deal. Looks like you're backing it up with the Apple.
I am backing it up with the Apple Ultra 2 watch.
Awesome.
It is, I'm still learning how to use it. It's a little bit more difficult to use than the Genius is. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to some training today, learning how to do some surveying and work on this dry suit deal.
Awesome. Ready to get going?
I'm ready to get going.
Let's rock and roll.
Let's rock and roll.
So there you go, guys. That's what we're wearing for today's survey dive. And like I said, stay tuned because we're going to be making a separate video showing you exactly how we do these underwater surveys and what they're actually for as well. But this is something that you can do. You know, even as an open water diver, as long as you're not going into an environment that is outside your training. And yes, docks, just like the dock I'm standing on, can be an overhead environment, but you can still do this safely. As long as you get proper training and what to do and you follow all local regulations and things like that, this is something an open water diver can do. So I'm gonna finish getting the boat loaded up really quick. We're gonna head up the lake, get this survey done, and then hopefully we'll have a good day and a good dive as well. But definitely stay tuned. We got the survey dive coming right after this one, and I really think you guys will enjoy it. That's gonna do it for today. Take care, God bless, and I'll see you in the next video.